All right, so we're going to run through another Source Mogul tutorial here. Now, I've been loving this software lately. It's a game changer for anyone doing online arbitrage from retail websites like you see here, right? Costco, Dick's, Home Depot, Walmart, anything like that, any retail websites where you're scanning that site and looking for a discrepancy in price from that site to Amazon so you can buy it from one place, ship it into FBA, and make a markup in profit. Okay, so I just scanned two last night. Let's check out Dick's. I haven't set this up. I haven't even looked at these yet. I'll run through this exactly like I would any other day by myself if you weren't here with me. Okay, now if you do need to understand, you know, how to basically go through and search them, why I use Source Mogul, what it basically is, you can check out the last tutorial that I did a few days ago. I'll make sure to drop that down at the bottom of the description. That will walk you through the initial process. You can watch that, then obviously watch the corresponding tutorial right after that, and then come back and watch this one so you get a better kind of look of different products, how to source through different websites, and you'll better understand how to utilize the software, okay? So I'm gonna click into Dick's right here, and we're gonna hit View Results. Now, I'm gonna set my initial ROI to about 30% here, and I'm gonna set my profit to about $7. That's what I usually like to start with. Sometimes I change it up, sometimes I change it down. I like to make things a little bit more specific initially, and then if it doesn't seem to work, I'll broaden it out so I see more products. That said, usually if you have a big store like Dick's or any of these stores, you know, really in the Source Mogul software, you will see a decent amount of products, you know, unless you're going super, super specific, okay? I also want my match rate accuracy all the way up, and I'm gonna go to my sales rank and filter it down to under 100,000. Now, I'm also gonna hit remove products without a buy box. So now you see that there's only three results here after the fact, right? Now, obviously I can broaden the search out a little bit more. If I wanted to find more products, I can drop this down to like 20%. But let's go through and check these three right here. Now, also, if you guys want Source Mogul, I do have a referral link. I'll make sure that's the second link in the description, followed by the first link in the description, which is the link to Online Arbitrage Pro. I've recently introduced a few payment plans into Online Arbitrage Pro that will help a lot of other people get into the course. It's really one of the best ways and the most recession-proof ways to make money online, because regardless of what happens, there will always be buy low and sell high. So lock down this skill now. It is a skill that you can utilize from your home to make money online. I highly recommend not just Source Mogul, but online arbitrage in general. So let's check out some of these right here. Now you'll see the discrepancy right here. Dick's is selling the same exact thing right here for $647. Amazon has it listed for $2077. Now because my match rate accuracy is all the way up, the further right you go, the lower chance that these will be the exact product. But because it's all the way up, you can pretty much not guarantee, but be almost sure that they're usually the same product roughly, but you still wanna always check them, okay? So I'm gonna click the Dick's thing right here, and I'm also gonna click the Amazon one, and I'm gonna find out if there are discrepancies in these actual flags and if they are actually the same. So I would need to look for some specs right here. It looks like this is 15 by 10.5, 15 by 10.5. It looks like it's the same exact flag right here. So this is selling for $23.69 on Amazon, and this is selling for $9.99 actually on Dick's. It might have gone up since I scanned it. It looks like it was $6.47. Is there a coupon code? No, there is not. So yeah, so it did go up. So then, but also it went up on Amazon as well, right? Because it told us that Amazon was selling it for $20 and Dick's was selling it for $6. When in reality, Dick's is selling it for $9.99 and Amazon is selling it for $23. So they both went up about $3, so there's still a good margin there to be made. Now you always want to make sure, right? So you want to go through the checklist. So you want to basically see, okay, if we buy this for X amount and we sell it back on Amazon for Y amount, is there a profit to be made? You also want to go through and you want to check to see, okay, can I actually sell this, right? That's always the number one thing that you want to do, right? You want to see, okay, the ASIN, copy it, take it into Seller Central, add a product, and see if you actually can sell it yourself, okay? Now, you also know that because I scanned this last night, it did change a little bit, so you do want to kind of scan. I don't ever recommend just like scanning a bunch of things in Source Mogul. If we go back to the software and we go to like status, I don't recommend scanning a few things. like you'll see here, and then going back and doing like old ones because they're gonna be outdated, right? Just like you're seeing here, the sales rank might change a little bit, the prices might change because I waited on them. So you wanna scan and then do it fairly quickly, ideally that same day, but if not, then try it the next day or maybe at most the day after that. But you don't wanna leave them there too long because things will change, prices will change, especially if they're running like a clearance or a sale, things could obviously change that way, okay? So now we wanna make sure that it is selling well, and obviously it's 116 in sports and outdoors, so it's selling decently. I'm gonna use the Jungle Scout Chrome extension to tell me exactly what it's selling. It's estimating about 30 a month, about one a day, so it's still selling, just not a lot. There's four people on the listing, but there is a profit to be made, so I would wanna check to see if I can make a profit, right? I'm gonna use the Amc Scout Calculator, and obviously I'll link Jungle Scout in the description too if you guys wanna go ahead and grab Jungle Scout. That is an affiliate link, helps me out obviously, but it helps you out. It's basically going to identify exactly what a product's selling for you. It is an estimate, keep that in mind, but it's gonna give you the sales velocity of that actual listing so you can better identify and gauge how many of a certain unit you wanna buy. It's vital, okay? So another one, this is free, AMZ Scout Calculator. I love this one. And we're gonna basically pop in $9.99 because that was our cost. I'm gonna estimate it cost me a buck to ship it into FBA. And that leaves my profit margin at about $6.65 per unit. So I don't wanna buy too many of these because there are four other people on the listing and there's only about one a day selling. So I wanna go to the online seller add-on, which is another free Google Chrome extension. And I'm gonna see exactly how many of these each person has in stock. So once this loads, it's gonna tell me. And while there are four other people, it doesn't look like anybody really has a good number in stock. And if you look, there's only one person that has an FBA offer and it is new, okay? So really, if I ship it into FBA, I'm only gonna be competing with this $23.69. So if I ship it into FBA, by the time it gets in there and these might be gone, I might be able to sell it for a little bit higher than these people right here because they're all FBM, as you can see. So I'm really only competing on price with the one person. So maybe I'd grab about five of these units and lock in like a $30 profit margin, but obviously I would make that call myself after the fact. I'm just kind of running through a tutorial to kind of show you how I'd approach this, okay? So usually I like to stay away from ones right here if there's no picture, but because we only have three results and it's a little bit specific right here, I'll click them and see if they're the same. So this is selling for 72 bucks, which seems ridiculous in my opinion. And that seems a little too good to be true. Plus there's shipping. So I'm gonna stay away from that because it's not a prime offer. And it just seems a little sketchy to me. Same thing with this one. This one looks like it's, this one's a little bit more normal. So 18, 12 and the Kansas City Chiefs pennant. We'll see what it's selling for on Dick's. And once it loads, we'll be able to see. So it does look like it's the same thing, $249 for this pennant right here. Is this the same pennant? It looks very similar. And I'm gonna go ahead and say that's roughly the same pennant. We've got the red on the thing. Yeah, that's roughly the same pennant. So, although the price did, wait, there's shipping here. So that is also sketchy and something I would probably stay away from. Although I'm gonna look more into it a little bit, right? It looks like the price has stayed steady right here. Although keep in mind that there's shipping involved there too. So if I shipped it in, it'd probably be like 18 bucks. And because this is super low and it does seem sketchy, I might still go after it because there's practically no risk here if I'm buying this for 250. So let me scroll down and check into it a little bit more. It's 142 in sports and outdoors, so that also is a little bit lower than I like to see. It's gonna tell me that it's selling about one a day, 45 a month. That could obviously fluctuate. So this is probably an item that if I were going, you know, to be perfectly honest, a little bit broader here, and there were a bunch of other items to, you know, kind of show you, I would avoid just because there's so many moving parts there. Obviously, you also wanna check the ASIN to see if you can sell it, but I might take a chance on this just because it's super low risk because I'm buying each one for $250. Maybe I buy like five of them, ship them in, and see if I can make a margin on it. Because if I could make a margin on it, let's just run the numbers here with the AMZ Scout calculator. And obviously, it's not going to pop it up this time. So if we took it the ASIN, another way, if you don't actually want to download that one, you can go into the Amazon FBA calculator, pull that up. It's the free one that Amazon gives you. And then just paste the ASIN in and then all the numbers as well. So the item price right here, I think, was roughly like $18.99 with shipping. Let's even go lower than that. Let's estimate $17.99. I'm gonna estimate it cost us a buck to ship it into FBA, and our cost of the product was $2.50. So there's still a decent margin here. I'm spending $2.50 to get $8.30 back. That's a pretty solid margin right there. So it might be something I take a chance on, although it is not ideal, okay? Now, if this were the case, usually you rarely see like three. I would obviously broaden this out a little bit. I may drop it down to like a 25% ROI and like a $6 profit margin. And you'll see, obviously, that's going to give me six of them now. So this one right here might be a good one too. Let's try one more. I don't want to waste your time. Obviously, I kind of want to just show you the process so that you can utilize the process yourself and find good products to buy. So let's go through one more example right here. This looks like it's the same product as well. Berkley Nano Unifil Fishing Line. Berkley Nano Unifil Fishing Line. It also has the same case, I guess, same product packaging. So Berkley Nano Fill Fishing Line, Berkley 6 pounds. Peel here, is this 6 pounds? It is. So while this does look relatively similar, oh, okay, here's a different one, Clear Mist. Is that the one right there, Clear Mist? Clear Mist. Okay, so we did find it. It's this one right here. It's the Clear Mist. So it is selling for $33.56 right here. And on Dick's, it looks like it's selling for $19.99, I believe. So if we get the 6 pound, because that's what the one in Amazon is, right? That's 8 pound, excuse me. 8 pounds. It's $38.99. So then that becomes a bad buy if you look the 8 pound 300 yards, 8 pound 300 yards. There is no margin on this anymore. So it looks like the price went back up. It could have been a sale. Maybe Dick's was running like a clearance sale or something like that. But that price isn't there anymore. So that's just a short tutorial of how to use Source Mogul to scan through retail websites. If you go to search and search by supplier like I've shown you in the past, there are a number of sites to scan here. It's super easy to scan them. You literally just click it and then click start search. It's going to scan through itself, right? You don't have to manually scan anymore. It's literally going to pull up the products super quickly. You come back like 5 to 10 minutes later and boom, you can view the results. So I'm going to actually sort through Costco now to source for myself, but I really hope that this tutorial actually helped you guys out so that you can more quickly, identify profitable products so you can make better judgment calls and buy more profitable products quicker. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I genuinely appreciate it. Also, remember, Online Arbitrage Pro 4.0 with new software and techniques just like this is linked. First link in the description. There is a full 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to lose. There is no better time to learn how to make money online than right now. So take the leap, learn it for yourself, and it will make a difference for you. I'll see you in the next one.